In this video, we will describe infusion cloning. Infusion cloning was the first commercial product to offer seamless or scarless cloning. The cloning mechanism does not require in vitro ligation. Any two fragments can be recombined at any location, and there will be no scar or residual nucleotides as a byproduct of cloning. Infusion cloning utilizes the DNA polymerase from vaccinia virus. This image from Swiss model highlights the exonuclease component in light purple. When given a substrate of blunt-end double-stranded DNA, the exonuclease will chew back from the 3' end, creating an asymmetrical overhang. This normal function of viral replication has been adapted for application in infusion cloning. An important predecessor to infusion cloning was the technique of stitching or sewing two PCR products together by making sure they had overlapping sequences at their ends. With both PCR stitching and infusion cloning, fragments must have overlapping regions of roughly 15 to 20 nucleotides. In PCR stitching, the overlap is exposed with heat. When performing infusion cloning, the vaccinia virus exonuclease enzymatically exposes the overlap. After degradation, Watson-Crick base pairing aligns the DNA fragments. With traditional ligation, a typical overlap is 4 base pairs long. This necessitates incubations at temperatures cool enough to stabilize the annealing of the ends, along with incubation with ligase. In contrast, the 15 to 20 base pair overlaps generated with infusion are stable at 30 to 37 degrees Celsius. As a result, these longer overhangs will remain duplexed after transformation into E. coli, at which point the duplexed plasmid and insert become subject to the final steps in E. coli's native DNA repair machinery. There are some final technical details to consider when performing infusion cloning. First, you have options to create your vector. You can either use inverse PCR or restriction digestion. Second, you may design up to 5 insert fragments to be introduced into your vector. This is accomplished by designing overlaps into the PCR primers so that the multiple fragments will align after treatment with infusion enzyme. To learn more about molecular cloning, visit snapgene.com.